head back to the 70s now and the sparkling pop songs of a loved-up couple who were among the biggest hit makers of the time, Captain and Tennille. You know all the songs, yeah. It takes you back, doesn't it? It seemed like the ultimate love story. Captain and Tennille were married for nearly 40 years, but somewhere along the line, the music died, and 2 years ago, Toni Tennille filed for divorce. She's just released her memoirs, and Toni Tennille joins us from New York.
Hi, everybody. Thank you.
Welcome to Studio 10. You and the Captain were married in 1975, the same year you released your first album together. Fans were understandably shocked and devastated when you split. What happened?
Well, you know, it took me 2 years to write the memoir, so it's kind of hard to distill it into a short thing. But Daryl and I always connected musically. That was the best part of everything that we did. But he was never able to be what I romantically thought he would be. I was raised in a very loving family, and love was a very big part of who I am. And his family was quite different, and he was a very closed-in man. It was very hard to reach, but I was convinced I could. It just would take me some time, and unfortunately, I was unable to do that. So here I am.
There were reports at the time that Daryl didn't see it coming, that he was devastated that you had filed for divorce.
He knew. He just didn't think I would do it. Yeah. And I'm not sure really how devastated he was, because, you know, he's fine now. I talk to him about every week or 10 days, and he has people that are doing the things for him that I used to do. So, and he seems happy. I know that seems odd. Well, he's not ever happy, but he seems fine.
Toni, you say that...
he's so hard to explain.
Toni, you say that you connected musically with Daryl because, I mean, listening to those love songs, they're just stunning. Yeah. They're exquisite. What was it like, though, when you then went off stage? I mean, you're singing these beautiful songs almost to him. What was life like behind that?
I was always trying to find the key to open Daryl's heart, I guess you could say. When I was a young kid, I learned a poem called Outwitted, and it said, "He drew a circle that shut me out. Heretic, rebel, a thing to flout. But love and I had the wit to win. We drew a circle that took him in." And that's what I thought I could do, and but I couldn't. And it was not Daryl's fault. There's nobody to blame except me, because he just was what he was, and he is what he is. And it just, I found myself going down into the negativity that he lives in all of his life, and I had to get out of that to have the rest of my life.
Have you met someone new?
Oh, are you kidding? No. Never. That's it. I'm done with that. I mean, I am 75 years old now,
oh,
and
you're
I
joking.
Don't want to do that anymore.
You look about...
No, I'm not.
55.
Yes.
You look fabulous.
Well, no. Yeah. Well, they must have the good filter on the TV right now. Yeah. So, you know, realistically, you think about it, I probably have 15 really good years left if I stay healthy, maybe more, but I wanted to live them, you know, happy. Mm. And I just couldn't be happy while I tried to make him happy unsuccessfully all those years.
Well, I hope you achieve it.
I'm very happy right now. I have my lovely family. I have my house in Lake Mary, Florida. And by the way, I just wanted to say, I love Australia. I love it. And I hope I can get back there sometime.
And we'll have more with Toni Tennille right after this very short break. Welcome back. We are speaking with Toni Tennille, one half of the pop sensations Captain and Tennille. They sold 25 million records in the 70s and 80s with hits such as Love Will Keep Us Together. Let's go back to Toni in New York now. And Toni, do you still perform?
Not right now. I've been actually under the radar for the past 8 years while I was trying to figure out what I was going to do and then finally make the decision to do it. I didn't talk to any press during all that time, so here I am making up for that. but I'm not sure what I'm going to do. I think I'm going to wait and see where life takes me after this is all over.
No. And Toni, obviously you and the Captain were married for 39 years. Why did it take so long for you to realise, I suppose, that you weren't in love and do something about it? Was it that long? I mean, better late than never, I guess, but it's a long time.
Happy times.
Yeah.
Well, I have to say that I was always in love. He never was. Or if he was, he never expressed it to me. In all that time, he never said the words, I love you.
Oh,
he just couldn't do it. He couldn't do it, and so I can't blame him. He had a very difficult family. He had a very I don't want to say overbearing, but mercurial father who was very critical of his kids. And I think that had a lot to do with the way Daryl was. But regardless, he was shut inside himself, and I couldn't bring him out. That's my great sad. That's the only thing that's sad for me when I think of everything Daryl still has to give. And he couldn't do it.
Aww. Wow. It sounds like, I mean, you did absolutely everything you possibly could. What was it like living with him day to day? I mean, there are stories that he always kept his hat on, those sorts of things.
Well, I do talk about that in the book. Mm. There were a lot of things that we didn't get to do because he refused to take his hat off. One was when we were in Rome and had a chance to go into the Sistine Chapel and he wouldn't take his hat off. And I should have said, well, heck with you, and gone in there by myself, but I didn't. Mm. I said, oh, okay, and went back to the hotel and the health food restaurant with him.
What was with the hat?
The hat. Well... his hair was thinning, and he was very, I guess a lot of men are very, conscious of it and worried about it. So he never took his hat off and even eventually got to the point where he wouldn't take it off at home.
He even kept it on in bed.
Well, yeah, he did, but it wasn't a captain's hat. It was just a regular old baseball cap.
So when Joe Cocker said you can leave your hat on, he actually took it really literally.
I love that. That the Randy Newman tune, you can leave your hat on. That's great.
Do you know what? When you're talking about him, I feel very sad for him that he's lived this life closed up. And you must have been a wonderful person to stay with him, hoping eventually that he was going to open up. Mm.
Well, either that or I was just stubborn and I don't know. I'm sure a lot of people think it was strange. But eventually, of course, I realized I wasn't going to be able to break through. And those were the years I spent trying to figure out what I was going to do about that.
Mm. And you released your first album together in 1974, and then I think you won a Grammy the year afterwards, which was the same year you got married. Mm-hmm. How much was your relationship kind of tied up in that fame juggernaut? Was it... Were you married to sort of... for appearances at first, or was it all true love and the music came second? How did it sort of all work?
Well, like I say, it was love on my part. And I wrote, songs like The Way I Want to Touch You, about how I felt for Daryl. Mm. I wrote Do That to Me One More Time about how I felt for Daryl. But the funny thing was, later on he told me he never paid any attention to lyrics, so he didn't know what I was saying. He was strictly a music man, and brilliant at it, I must say.
He didn't deserve you. You're an absolute darling.
Oh, he did. You know, the thing that we did together musically, I think, made it all worthwhile. Mm. You know, you have to sacrifice some things for others, and that's the way I'm looking at it now.
Mm. You were together married for 39 years. Obviously, there must have been some sort of happiness. And, I mean, do you regret those 39 years?
No, I don't. And the happiness was the joy of the music. And like I say, that was the one thing that Daryl and I had together that was wonderful. In other words, I knew that he thought I was a great singer and he thought I was a wonderful songwriter, and that was how I could win his approval, even though I could never get the romantic love that I wanted from him because he simply couldn't do it. But I knew how much he respected my talent and my abilities, and that was enough to go on for a while.
Toni, it's so lovely chatting with you, and we've been singing some of your songs off air. Do you think you could join us in Do It To Me One More Time?
We're ready.
Well, I know.
Hang on, we'll start it. You'd come along with us. Do it to me one more time.
Wait. It's not do it to me. It's do that to me. Do it to me is kind of blatant.
That's why you're the professional.
I'm much more subtle than that. But you sounded really good.
Thank you.
Lovely. Thank you. Toni's very personal memoir is out now and available where all good books are sold. Toni Tennille, thank you very much for joining us. What a delight.
What a beautiful, beautiful woman.